Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the channel. I'm excited to be with you again. Got a lot of positive feedback last week on this update where I just kind of give you some life updates and yeah, talk you through what I've been doing this week. So I'm going to do it again and see if you guys like it again. And if you do, I'm considering maybe turning it into a podcast. So let me know, I guess, if you think that would be good. Should I turn this into a podcast? Do you guys want to hear audio of what I'm doing on a day-to-day basis or a week-to-week basis? Life updates and baseball updates and all that. If you do, leave me a comment down below and say yes, or say yes podcast or something like that. Let me know that you want that. If not, no big deal. Tell me I'm dumb and have terrible ideas. That'd be great too. So, disclaimer before I get going on today's episode. If my phone is blowing up during this episode, it's because I just roasted Clev on Twitter and he's probably going to text me. He'll see it at some point soon, or just notifications on Twitter are going to be going off like crazy. It'll be fun. Maybe get all the salty Astros fans out of my mentions that have been going after me for like the last 5 days or something like that. They just can't get over me, you know? It's just amazing. You make one reference to baseball being back and like doing everything you can to win for your team. You just post a harmless picture and all of a sudden they just come out of the woodworks and they're like, oh, you suck. And I don't even know what else they're saying. I threw a ball over center field and I have a career 4 ERA. And which, by the way, I've had like an ERA plus, well above league average for the past like 4 or 5 years. Have a sixth place finish in Cy Young and probably would have finished top 2 or 3 or won it if I didn't get hit in the ankle. And also, not to mention, I'm 8-0 against them with a 2-9. Like, they've never beaten me. So all you salty Astros fans, thank you for coming to the channel if you're here. And thanks for all the comments and stuff on Twitter. Helps me grow. Appreciate you guys. First thing, let's go over some spring training, or I guess summer camp. What is it called? Is it spring training version 2 or is it summer camp? I really have no idea. All I know is it's in Cincinnati, it's baseball, and it's hot. It is really hot. It is humid and really hot, and I've been sweating a lot. But it's baseball, it's fun. It's been going great so far. There's obviously all the regulations that we're having to get used to and some of the stuff like that. But yeah, we're getting going. I got my first outing under my belt. I went 3 innings, threw 50 pitches, plus an extra pitch at the end, which I'll talk about in a second. But I was pleased with it. I sat 94, 96, touched 97. All my stuff was sharp. I thought my command was much improved from what I was anticipating for my first outing. Generally speaking, when I get on the mound for the first time against hitters with cleats in a competitive setting, I spray balls everywhere because it's new, it's different. No matter how much you play indoors or in a cage or like in the desert or throw off a mound or see hitters or all this different stuff, it's just different when you get on the mound in cleats and a hitter's in the box, and a catcher back there, and you see a stadium around you. So I was really pleased with that. I thought my command was a lot better than I was expecting. My command was not nearly as good as it has been in training sessions, so I'm assuming that a little bit of that rust is from what I just discussed and just kind of being back on the mound for the first time. So I got another outing coming up here soon, a couple days, and so I'm excited to see how my command plays there. I got a swing and miss on a changeup below the zone, which doesn't happen for me very often, and got a lot of really good feedback on that pitch, which is great news because I've worked on it a lot. I've spent, a large part of the last, what is it now? 7 months, November, December, January, February, March, April, May, June, 8 months, 8.5 months working on that pitch. And so good to see some positive results coming out of that. I don't have any high speed footage of it yet, so it's hard for me to check the seam shifted wake effect that I'm hoping to get. So shout out to Barton Smith for coining that term. For those of you who don't know who Barton Smith is, you should look him up if you're interested in the physics of baseball, which probably means like zero of you watching this. But if you are, I think he's at Not Real Certain on Twitter. I could be wrong on that. I'll have to check. But yeah, Barton Smith, he's a really, really bright guy who loves baseball. He's doing a ton of work and research on the aerodynamics, the differing aerodynamics of how the seams, the orientation of the seams spinning on the ball affect the movement of it. So really interesting stuff. I've been talking to him for a while, but yeah, trying to get that seam shifted wake on the changeup. So got a lot of good feedback on that. Cutter was velocity-wise right where I wanted it, so that was positive. It got really slow at the end of last year because I couldn't really I was all banged up. But that was super positive. So got a lot of swing and miss on my fastball as well. I was really happy with it overall. And then at the end, you know, I dominated Nick Castellanos twice. I punched him out twice. And then at the end, he got really mad because he missed a pitch, a couple pitches that he should have hit, and he popped one out to right field. So I was like, hey, you want to like get back in the box? I'll give you a free pitch. You know, I feel bad for you. I'll give you a free pitch. I'll throw you a heater down the middle and see what you do with it. And for those who don't know, who haven't seen my Twitter and seen the video I posted.
There's an old saying in Tennessee. I know it's in Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, fool me once, shame on you. If fool me, we can't get fooled again.
In a game last year on Father's Day, I threw a complete game shutout against Detroit for my dad, Warren. So shout out to Warren. But in that game, I actually was in a 3-2 count with Nick. It was a long at bat and I just wanted it to be over. So I signaled fastball to him and got him to swing at a bad pitch, broke his bat, grounded out to second. So this time when I told him to get back in the box, I signaled fastball to him and he hit it about 550 feet. I mean, he did not miss a single part of that ball. It went halfway up the upper deck in left field. I mean, just absolutely obliterated. It was actually really good to hear because I've missed the sound of that, like off the bat. Like it's just a distinct sound. When someone gets every bit of a baseball with a wood bat, it's a very distinct sound. Baseball is like back officially. I've given up an absolute nuke of a home run. So that was good, and he had some bat flip and helmet flip and some celebration, and we laughed about it and talked about it, and I made a video, cut together some clips from George Bush, George W. Bush, and you know, there's an old saying in Tennessee and the hand, so I cut that whole thing together. I put last year's me signaling fastball and breaking his bat. And this year's homer, it was great. It was really fun. So any way we can jack up the competition in this time right now, I mean, we got like 2 weeks basically until first season game. And then it's a really short sprint to the finish line, 60 games. So everything is gonna be super important. So anything we can do to jack up the competition in practice and make it game-like and like talk some crap back and forth and you know, simulate things being important and intense and like really competing, I'm all for it. So, you know, we were jawing back and forth and having a good time with it. And it was a really productive day, a really fun day. It was the first time I really got to be in that competitive setting. I was able to flip the switch and put myself in that competitive setting, even though it was against my teammates, who I'm, you know, boys with all of them, obviously. So, yeah, it was great. It was a lot of fun. Really happy with where everything's at and just the competition. The team's looking great. Pitchers looking great. Hitters are like actually well ahead of where I anticipated they would be. I mean, it's so hard not seeing pitching for a long time. Like it's been, I think we got like 2 weeks of games in spring training, but again, it's been about 8 months, 9 months since we've seen pitching on a regular basis. So hitters are actually doing pretty well in given those circumstances. So really happy with where the team is at. I'm really excited to get going and play against some other people and see what we got this year, because I think we've got a really good chance to win. So that'll be exciting for all my Reds fans, all the fans of all the other teams that are tuning in. Sorry, it's not going to be your year. You guys can come in second, and we're going to win. So get that out of the way. I got some momentum updates. We got some really cool stuff that we're doing. We got some really fun stuff coming out. Backlogged footage that we shot in spring training that's getting all edited, and it's like really, really, really good, really, really compelling. So that stuff will be out coming up. I can't give you too many details on it yet, but I mean, starting the season off with a bang. Baseball's gonna be back and momentum's gonna hit the ground running with some brand new, really electric, fun content. So look out for that. And then we got some stuff that we'll be producing during this season. Getting that out to you guys, as always, trying to connect you as much as we can with your favorite players and connect them with their favorite fans and really help grow the game of baseball, which is what we're all about, connecting fans and players on a human level and just trying to get some young fans, trying to get some interest around the game and get the personalities that I see on a daily basis out there. I mean, I'm in the clubhouse. We had a crazy conversation just earlier today about, you know, different conspiracy theories and just all the crazy things that are online. Go down a rabbit hole one night on YouTube and you bring it in the clubhouse and you're talking about it and everyone's laughing and making fun of you. And just those moments that are so fun and like really depict what a baseball season is about for the players that are in the clubhouse. We're trying to get more of those out to you. Trying to get some of those stories, some of those laughs, those conversations, trying to bring those to you, the fans, so you have more of an idea what it's like to live this crazy life that we're living. So really excited about that. But if you haven't already, go check out Momentum. It's watch-momentum.com. It's watch_momentum on socials and watch-momentum on different socials, all linked in my bio on Twitter and Instagram and all that. So I'm sure y'all are plenty familiar with Momentum, being loyal followers of mine. I appreciate that. But if you haven't already, go check them out. Lots of fun content coming out this year. A little bit of update on my apartment. I've been really busy for the past week and I've done basically nothing to finish moving in. I still got some suitcases sitting out. I still haven't unpacked some things. I still haven't gotten my studio room that I'm excited about set up yet. So I'm still here in my dining room making this video and getting content out to you all. So that's one of the updates. One of the things I have gotten set up is my infrared sauna, and I'm excited about that. I'm back on that train, using it again. Wake up in the morning, take my daily measurements, and then I sit in the sauna for 20, 25 minutes, get a really good sweat in and take a cold shower, and then I feel like I'm ready to go for the day. So that's been a big part of my routine, been conducting business calls while in the sauna, connecting with all my analysts and just everyone that is in my circle, doing interviews, stuff like that. So got that set up. I have my bird charging station. I have, for those of you who don't know, I have a bird scooter. I'm actually living on the Kentucky side of the river in Cincinnati area this year. So I've been birding to the field most days. It's nice to just kind of get outside and ride and have a little bit of fun getting there. Driving kind of gets stale sometimes. So I've been riding my bird to the field every day. did not account for the fact that sometimes there are thunderstorms that pop up in this area in the evening. So the other day, get done at the field with workouts, I shower, I change, got my little backpack on with my food in it. I'm ready to go home and I got an interview I had a company meeting actually in like 15 minutes. And it takes me probably like 10 minutes to get home. So I'm ready to go. I'm riding out from the underground parking lot and I see a massive storm cloud and just downpours of rain and wind going all over the place. And it's like right there. It's like not quite to me yet, but it's, I don't know, maybe 200 feet away is what it seemed like. And you can like hear it coming and it's thundering and lightning. And I'm like, oh no, I'm gonna get caught in a downpour. And downpours here are not like, I mean, I grew up in California, all right? So downpours in California was like kind of misty rain. Like it didn't rain that hard, the droplets weren't that big. But Midwest thunderstorms, I mean, I'm sure you all know, Midwest thunderstorms are like heavy droplets, like downpour. You get soaked in a second. Something I got experience with in Texas when I moved to Texas back in 2011 in the Houston area, so. I was nervous. It got a little bit wet out there. My bird was drifting. I was drifting my bird, not intentionally. It got a little sketchy, little freaked out, almost ate it a little bit, but managed to get home safe and sound and just barely beat the thunderstorm. Did not get soaked. My hair got wet enough though. My hair's like too long right now. I need to cut it. But my hair got wet enough that like riding and there's wind hitting it that I had this little poof in front of like where the wind was like blowing my hair up. And so when it dried, I had this like really bad hairstyle going on. Not that my hairstyle is ever good, but it was just extra bad at that point. So that was a funny experience, but yeah, been enjoying riding the bird and getting outside. It's been enjoyable. Let's see, what else we got? Oh, yeah, interviews. So I got to hop on Pardon My Take again recently and hang out with PFT and Big Cat. That's always fun. Those guys, I mean, it's entertaining, all right? Regardless of how you feel about Barstool, it's entertaining to hang out and talk to those guys. I mean, they make it really fun. It's a really fun interview. They ask some fun questions. They ask some tough questions. They joke about it. It's a good time. It fits in perfectly with my personality. I get to make fun of myself a lot. They get to make fun of me a lot, which really works. It's just, I'm used to being made fun of. So it was great. I enjoyed it. That episode is out now. If you haven't checked it out, go check them out because I appreciate them having me on. So giving those guys a little shout. I'm sure you guys all follow Barstool anyway, since they're much bigger and more popular than I am and probably will ever be. So that's good. But that was fun. I got to talk a little bit about the baseball's back tweet that I sent out that I referenced earlier, about trolling the Astros a little bit. I got to talk a little bit about throwing the ball over center field, if I'm going to bring that back this year or not. What do you guys think? Should I bring that back? Should I do that again? Should that be my thing now? Just every time I get pulled, just launch the ball into center field? Nah, probably won't be. But yeah, I got to talk about that a little bit. I got to talk about the negotiations and just, it was fun. It was fun catching up with those guys again, you know? They do a great job. It's an entertaining show and happy to be on and join them anytime that they want me back. So thanks to those guys. A really cool experience from today at the field. I connected with a young kid on Twitter, his family actually, and his name's Hudson. And we were gonna bring him out to a game this year and have him meet some of the team and hang out at batting practice, and like really special kid and great family, and you know, was looking forward to having him out and getting to meet him and all that. Unfortunately, with COVID, we can't have fans out of the stadium. So made a little video for him today. We're gonna send him a care package. We're gonna let him know that the Reds are thinking about him, the players are thinking about him, that we hope he's doing well. And yeah, it's those moments too that, you know, you kind of take them for granted when in the off season, because you forget about them a little bit. And when during season, they happen all the time. You know, kids come out to batting practice, they're there, you get to stop, sign some autographs, you get to talk to them a little bit, hear their stories, and just see the love for baseball. You know, they're just having such a great time out of the ballpark with their family, and just like, it's great to see. It reminds you of why you started playing that game, because almost all the big leaguers like were in those shoes in some way. They were looking up to their favorite big league star as a kid. They were going to games looking for autographs. They were watching on TV and saying, man, if one day I could just do that, like, that would be a dream come true. So like having those moments, I think that I'm going to miss that this year, you know, not having fans out there to be able to connect with them and hear their stories and what they're going through in life and why baseball means so much to them and all that. So, yeah, one of the fun things I got to do today that reminds me of the things that, you know, I won't get to do this season, but I'm going to have to find some creative ways to continue connecting with people like that and helping, you know, grow their love for the game. So that was really fun. Wanted to give Hudson a shout out, let him know that we're thinking about him. One other thing, I got my water here, gonna knock my phone over. Clev still hasn't texted me. That's BS. I know he's on it. I know he's looking at Twitter. I know it. I know he is. He probably has tweeted me, he just hasn't thought to text me yet. But anyway, I'm getting a little parched here. Got my water here, and I've been having a little trouble breathing at night. My nose is kind of swollen inside, so it's been a little bit tough to breathe through my nose. So trying to drink some extra water and hydrate and see if that helps. I've been chasing this thing for like a year and haven't figured out a thing, you know, one thing that can really make a difference here. But yeah, trying water and seeing if, I mean, I know that's one of the things that you should always, I mean, you should always be hydrated, but been trying to drink a lot and run a little case study on myself this past week. Really get super hydrated. I'm measuring my hydration right before bed and in the morning to collect some data on that, adding that to my spreadsheet to see if we can make some changes, my sleep data tracking and all the different spreadsheets. I have so many spreadsheets on my phone, it's ridiculous. When I go to, I got my workout spreadsheet, I got daily tracking spreadsheet, I got sleep tracking spreadsheet, I got momentum tracking spreadsheet and content, I got social media, it's ridiculous. I have a long list on Google Sheets that I use every single day. I'm such a nerd. Who else uses spreadsheets? That's weird. But last thing. All right, what I tweeted Clev about is when we match up this year, I have some custom cleats, and I am so excited for my custom cleats. I gotta tell you, I got three of them right now. I'm gonna just, you guys probably just don't even wanna look at me, so I'll just hide behind my cleats. Now, I got three pairs of custom cleats. I'm not gonna show them to you because I have plans for these, but I got three pairs of fire custom cleats. I got a couple more coming. I got some sick cleats that Nike gave me as my base cleats, and then I got these ones that are painted and designed in all sorts of really cool ways. I got big plans for these guys. Big plans. So one of them is going to be when I match up with Cleveland and we match up with Clev, and hopefully we pitch against each other, but I'm going to win that cleat battle. I'm determined. There's no chance that his cleats are cooler than the ones I'm planning on wearing against him. And I challenge him in the next, I guess it's 3.5 weeks, to come up with something that he thinks can compete with my cleats. I'll have more for you guys on that in a bit, in a future video. I got all sorts of fun plans. It's gonna be great. A lot of fan involvement. I'm gonna give all my followers a little entertainment, a little fun. I can't reveal too much yet, but it's gonna be a great time. So excited for that. Got those custom cleats. They came in, I cannot wait for Clev to respond, honestly. He's got to tweet me back. Anyway. That's really all for the updates. I think I got through pretty much everything. I got my Frenchie mask here. I got, you know, wearing this at the field. I don't know if you guys can see that or not, but you got Toby on here, cute little French bulldog. So that's about it. I'm gonna go get some sleep because I got another interview in the morning. And more phone calls and more content to make and businesses to run and hitters to strike out. I got a bullpen tomorrow. I got, life goes on. So thank you all for joining me. Appreciate you. If you watched to the end, I appreciate that. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Help me out on my way to 100,000 by the end of 2020. Leave me a comment. Let me know if you'd like me to turn this into a podcast, if you like this format and you want me to keep it going during season. That's basically it. That's all I got for you. Have a good one.